Hey everyone, this is Lorenzo from Hacking Your Leadership and welcome to another Thoughtful Thursday episode. Thank you for your continued support and please subscribe, like, and share the podcast. Follow us on Instagram at Hacking Your Leadership and give us a rating and review on your favorite listening platform. On this episode, I want to talk about Uncle Rico Syndrome. Many of you may be asking, what the heck is that? Well, in short, I was watching a cast reunion YouTube video for the cult movie Napoleon Dynamite that celebrated the 15-year release anniversary a few weeks ago. If you haven't seen this movie, I would highly suggest it, but it would only make sense if you get 80s references and enjoy socially awkward humor. Anyways, there's a character called Uncle Rico who was middle-aged and constantly references his high school sporting achievements. I think everyone has someone in their family that quote-unquote lives in the past and desperately holds on to those old wins. While watching this reunion, I started to think about how during interviews, sometimes I run across people who provide examples from years ago or at previous employers, and I immediately wonder if they are simply emotionally attached to old work or maybe they just needed more time to process a more recent example. Either way, I believe it's a direct reflection of people sometimes being stuck understanding the difference between what you did and what you are currently doing. I didn't really consider making a Thoughtful Thursday about this topic until I started reading a new book that was released last week by Scott Miller called Everyone Deserves a Great Manager. If you haven't yet, check out Scott's guest series show and click the link in the show notes to purchase the book. In his book, he talks about common mindsets and effective mindsets in his chapter titled Develop a Leader's Mindset. What caught my attention was a quote that read, "Hold a funeral for your old job." He goes on to say, when you become a leader, your definition of results needs to change. You need to see them differently. When you were an individual contributor, your results were the work you did. But now that you are a leader, you own the results of everybody on your team. I really like this clarification of how leaders should measure success, and it also serves as a reminder that your previous goals, accomplishments, and awards should be appreciated for the lessons they taught and the validation they gave you. But now that you work in service of your people, it's their success and accomplishments that matter more than yours ever did. Thanks for listening, and talk to you all next week.